2020 was a very good year for SpaceX. In 2020, Elon Musk's business launched 26 missions, breaking the previous calendar year record of 21 set in 2018. But the now second richest man in the world has a more eventful plan for 2021 and a very busy summer. In today's video, we'll take a look at the recent updates on Starship SN11 and the bold plans SpaceX has for orbital flights this summer. On Thursday, following a wipe on Mondays, Starship SN11 will re-tempt the static fire test before a possible flight as soon as the weekend or the start of the following week. In the future, the SN11 will mark the final test of this iteration of Starship before it moves into the next testing phase. Well, after SN11, SpaceX will move on to SN15, 16, and 17 together, with tests using the BN1 and BN2 prototypes, Super Heavy, before firing up with the SN20 and BN3 for orbital launch. This orbital launch has an astounding and unlikely by July 1st target in the typical SpaceX style. This objective at least represents the Starship drive of SpaceX to put the vehicle into operation. By the way, if you like our content, then show us some love and remember to subscribe to our channel, Futurephile, to watch more fascinating videos about such fascinating futuristic tech. The SN11. This will be the fourth high-altitude flight test for the Starship prototype, and while efforts are continuing to focus on the refining of the flight profile, the vehicle has already achieved many milestones, including the proven long-lasting performance and controllability of Raptor during ascent. SpaceX Boca Chica has meanwhile released Starships at such a high rate that they are capable of quick turnarounds, which allow the rocket to be tweaked prior to the next flight after each launch. If you remember, the SN8 maneuver made the flip before a loss of thrust due to a pressure drop in the header tank that led to its rapid unscheduled disassembly, also known as RUD. Due to engine-related problems, the SN9 did not complete the flip. All maneuvers were carried out before the header tank was hard to land, eventually causing the vehicle to explode seconds later upon touching the landing pad. These problems are mitigated through the last few seconds of flight. SpaceX has decided in post-SN8 to add the methane header tank and SN9 helium pressurization. Following the relight problem of the SN9 motor, SpaceX chose to light all three motors in SN10 flash and burn in case they would all reach successfully before unloading the engine. During SN10's flip, all three engines did relight before the system decided to land on just one of them. Even though the landing velocity appeared to be adequate at first glance, SpaceX CEO and chief designer Elon Musk quickly confirmed that he was still too high. A few of the landing legs also failed to lock into place, though Elon pointed out that the high-velocity landing would have squashed them regardless. Elon pointed that the hard landing was caused by the Raptor ingesting helium that was pressurizing the CH4 header tank during the landing burn. Other than Elon's remark that various fixes are in the works, it's unclear what refinements are being made for SN11's flight. One change that is likely to occur during SN11's landing is the use of two engines rather than one to counter potential thrust loss and increase redundancy during the no room for failure landing burn. Whatever changes in flight, the SN11 test campaign has been mainly planned during pad flow, with tests already carried out in ambient and cryogenic conditions. By the end of last week, the static fire test was anticipated. However, understood to be GSE-related issues, the SN11 Raptors have been delayed for firing because of the requirement that Road 4 should be closed during such tests at weekends. SpaceX only calls for a few weekend road closures to minimize local disruption. 15th August, Monday morning, was the latest static fire window, which could be launched the following day, but weather conditions were still acceptable. SN11 attempted to test despite the foggy conditions, but it was aborted shortly after afterburner ignition. Another attempt was scheduled for Thursday, March 18th in the morning. The next possible attempt for SN11 is on March 22, Monday. According to Christian Davenport of the Washington Post, the FAA, Federal Aviation Administration, officially approved the SN11 flight on Monday. Future vehicles. After launching SN11, as we've already mentioned, SpaceX will proceed to Starship SN15, skipping SN12, 13, and 14 as previously reported by NASASpaceflight.com. SN15 involves a new thrust pack design as well as a slew of other largely unnoticed enhancements. As part of the heat shield testing program, it will most likely have an extra thermal protection system, TPS. This fire engine is currently parked in the mid-bay, waiting for its turn on enter the high bay to stack nose cones. The two large tankage sections for the first Super Heavy prototype, BN-1, are currently occupying the high bay. BN-1 should not be flying. It will then be stacked and rolling to the suborbital Starship pad for ground testing, which includes possible static fire testing. This will provide important data in advance of the BN-2 test flight, sections of which were already found waiting to stack. Before SN15 goes on the pad for its test flight, the BN-1 test project is supposed to happen. After SN15 comes into its pad flow, the new testing campaign is expected to be launched, with SN16 and SN17 being joined by three starships. BN-1, BN-2, and the new starships are documented data showing that the vehicles are significantly enhancing their design and serving as production paths to support the increased production cadences, according to NASA Spaceflight. SpaceX may also skip the production of the SN18 and SN19 starships, which are based on non-referenced vehicles. This matched that as SpaceX decided to advance from SN11 to SN15, SN12, 13, and 14 were also dismantled. In particular, the NASA spaceflight data, which are always subject to change, also adds a fascinating note about the first orbital flight that includes Super Heavy BN-3 and Starship SN20. Although this date is at best highly ambitious, SpaceX shows its drive to ship Starship as an absolute target in orbit this year. However, when asked on Twitter, Elon confirmed that this is our goal. This goal is also supported by visual work on the rockets and the launch site. Testing the reaction of the material and its attachments during prop loading and flight stresses with the application of TPS to patches of the existing Starships will include whole sections of the future Starships and hexagon tiles. This procedure, which covers the vehicle's entire windward side, will be required for missions in which starships return from space and are subjected to re-entry heating. It's also conceivable that a starship ahead of SN20 will be given a huge amount of TPS to boost performance data before SN20's launch into space. At the orbital launch site, a significant amount of work is also being done. The first Super Heavy mount is already waiting for its launch table, as well as the construction of a massive integration tower, which will include not only mate Starship with the booster while on the mount, but also a crane to lift. The first of the new propellant tanks arrived at the launch facility just last week, ready to extinguish future Super Heavy boosters' thirst. The aforementioned information also stated that instead of landing legs, the orbital launch pad would be capable of catching the booster, as Elon had previously stated on social media. On the integration tower, this would entail catcher's arms. If SpaceX continues to target BN-3 for the orbital mission, this is unlikely to be ready in time for BN-3's flight, given that plans at SpaceX Boca Chica are constantly changing. Despite the impressive pace of construction at the launch site, a BN-3 SN20 launch by July 1 is all but impossible. However, with the integration tower potentially only a week away from rising from the ground, an orbital mission later this year is looking increasingly likely. Other plans for the summer. According to a military spokesman, SpaceX plans two Falcon Heavy launches for the U.S. Space Force this year in July and October, and United Launch Alliance has four national security space missions on its 2021 schedule. The Falcon Heavy missions will be SpaceX's fourth and fifth missions with the triple core heavy lifter. Both launches will take place from Florida's Kennedy Space Center's Pad 39A. USSF 44 is the first Space Force mission on a Falcon Heavy rocket this year. According to a Space Force spokesman, the mission will launch in July. Since its debut in February 2018, the Falcon Heavy has flown four times, including the USSF 44 mission. The Falcon Heavy will supply a high-elevation, geologically synchronous USSF 44 mission with several military payloads. The upper stage of the rocket will fire several times to position the satellites more than 22,000 miles over the equator. The top-level flight profile includes a coastline between burns that lasts more than 5 hours, making the USSF 44 mission the most demanding launch of SpaceX. The upper story of the rocket completed four burnt operations on a demonstration flight sponsored by the Air Force on the most recent Falcon Heavy mission in June 2019. During the last July mission, 24 satellite payloads were placed in three distinct orbits during complex orbital maneuvers before the Air Force entrusted the launcher with more critical and costly operational national security payloads on future flights, such as the USSF 44 mission. It also exercised the capability of the Falcon Heavy and its Merlin upper stage engine. In February 2019, SpaceX won a contract to launch the USSF 44. The military asked prospective launch operators to accept that the combined mass of the mission's two payloads of less than 8,200 pounds, or about 3.7 metric tons, was assigned to the USSF 44. The literal star-struck space transportation company, with their teams of geniuses, seems to have their plate full for this summer with numerous space travels, which leave those of us space nerds with a lot to look forward to this summer. If you like this video, you may also like to watch the video shown in this end screen about when will SN11 launch. See you there.